What's up, Good Life Kids? Thanks so much for joining us today. We're going to get our time started off by worshiping together through song and dance. So go ahead and get on your feet. What better way to start the day than to sing songs to Jesus, knowing that He is our only hope? Speaking of hope, we're going to now watch a video that highlights a ministry going on in South Africa called Door of Hope. Let's check it out.
The first day I ever arrived, I walked into the door, and on the floor there was this blanket, and it was covered with babies, 11 squirmy little bodies all over this floor.
Door of Hope is an orphanage for abandoned babies here in South Africa, around the Johannesburg area.
There is a church where there's a hole in the wall and there's a door. So if a mother who cannot take care of her baby or doesn't want her baby, she knows she can go to this church and place her child in this bin, in this hole in the wall, and know that he's going to have a brighter future.
And then a sensor will go off and the workers will come pick up the baby and care for it. It's a service truly doing what God calls us to do. He says to help the poor. He says to help those that can't help themselves. He says to make others happy, to glorify His name. And Door of Hope does all that. It takes a baby who's completely helpless and gives it a new life that it would have never had otherwise. And then with the Door of Hope putting the baby into an adoption process, it makes another family happy. It provides a child for a family that maybe wouldn't have one otherwise.
God has given me a passion for children, and so at the Door of Hope, I'm really God's hands and feet. I'm the face of Jesus to these little abandoned babies. You see just how faithful God has been to their little lives, that instead of dying in the street, you know, their mother chose life for them, or they were found by someone, and they were given a second chance. And so just being there and loving on them and showing them, yes, you have a hope and a future, I think that's just so incredibly heartwarming for these children to know, and so incredibly important for them to know.
When they find out what their life was like when they were little, they're going to be like, wow, there were so many aunties, so many volunteers that cared enough about me to raise me. And so I just feel like the love and affection that I'm able to show to these babies and providing their physical needs too, it really does make a difference to them.
The Bible says that we are to take care of orphans and widows in their distress. And it's very important that we take care of these children because that's what Jesus commands us to do. He wants us to give these children a new hope and a new future because he loves the children and he doesn't want them to be abandoned or to be lost, but he always seeks and saves us.
Wow, what an incredible organization. They definitely are living their life to bring glory to Jesus. Speaking of giving glory, apparently someone named Hunt Burkleton has a story developing over at the Mooseberry about bringing God glory. Let's go check it out.
And now, a special report from Hunt Burkleton.
Followers of Jesus. Who are they? What do they do? Where do they learn it? And can they communicate with dolphins? I'm guessing no to that last one, because dolphins are a made-up animal.
They're totally real.
I'm investigative reporter Hunt Burkleton, and this is Hunt Burkleton Knows What's Really Going On with Followers of Jesus. We know that being a follower of Jesus means getting to know Jesus and his plans through prayer and reading the Bible. But what else can his followers do?
Ooh, I know the answer to this one.
Oh, really? Do tell.
No comment.
Here's something his followers can do. Stop sending me invitations to church that are filled with glitter.
I made the invitation myself and filled it with glitter.
I like glitter.
Glitter? This news hound can't help but wonder if glitter has something to do with following Jesus. Maybe his followers just really like to make sparkly crafts?
If they do, it's not until they're done doing unicycle stunts.
You don't have to like glitter and do stunts or whatever to follow Jesus.
As a follower of Jesus, I can tell you what's important is to praise Jesus. Praising Jesus means you give him glory.
And of course, glory means to glue something to someone named Lori.
Not even close.
We give Jesus glory by loving him. We can do that by singing, or writing poems, or stories, or by telling other people how good he is.
You could use your art, including glitter.
Or your excellent fashion sense.
Or by doing awesome stunts.
It sounds like there are endless ways to praise Jesus.
Praise is a way to share how great Jesus is. You can use your talents, your money, your personality, whatever.
And there you have it. Praise, a major part of what it means to be a follower of Jesus. Join me next time as we ask the question, if Jesus died, can he still be alive?
Absolutely.
The answer may surprise you.
No, it won't. I just said it.
Until then, I'm investigative reporter Hunt Burkleton, and this is Hunt Burkleton Knows What's Really Going On.
So good life, kids. We want to be people who praise God and that he may be glorified through our lives. We're going to check out our Bible story now, and it has to do with the time that Jesus was being praised and glorified. Let's check it out.
Jesus traveled with his disciples to Jerusalem. As he came to the Mount of Olives outside the village called Bethany, he sent two disciples ahead of him. As you enter the village, Jesus said, you will find a young donkey tied there. No one has ever ridden it. Untie it and bring it to me. If anyone asks what you're doing, say, the Lord needs it. But get this, the disciples found the donkey just like Jesus said. And when the owners asked why they were untying it, a reasonable question, I think, the disciples explained, the Lord needs it. And just like Jesus said, the owner of the donkey was totally cool with it. So they led the donkey to Jesus. They threw their robes on his back and helped Jesus get on. In the Old Testament times, a prophet had written, "Don't be afraid, your king is coming," sitting on a donkey's colt. And that prophecy came true as the donkey carried Jesus towards Jerusalem. people took palm branches and went out to meet Jesus. They spread their robes on the road where he was riding and shouted, "Hosanna, save us!" The people praised God for all the miracles Jesus had done and loudly said, "Blessed is the King who comes in the name of the Lord. Peace in heaven, glory in the highest heaven." But some of the Pharisees, the religious leaders, in the crowd were upset by what was happening. They told Jesus to tell his disciples to stop shouting. I guess they were, like, super jealous. But Jesus told the Pharisees, even if the people were silent, the stones would cry out. Jesus' disciples didn't understand what was happening at first. Later, after Jesus rose from the dead, they remembered and understood what had happened on that day.
Good life, kids. My hope for us is that we can be a people who lives our life to bring glory to God. In 1 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 31, it says, "So whether you eat or drink or whatever you do, do everything for the glory of God." So good life, kids, let's be people who live to praise Jesus and to glorify him, because he's worthy of it. Because of his life, his death, and his resurrection, he is worthy of all of our praise. And next week is Easter Sunday, and so please either attend in service or watch online, because we are going to get to hear more about how Jesus's life, death, and resurrection is him showing and revealing his great, great love for us. We've got a fun craft that goes along with today's lesson. Make sure you check that out on our website, as well as the coloring pages and the activity page. I'm going to pray for us, and then we'll close out our time in worship. But thank you so much for joining us today. Jesus, thank you so much for the way that you love us and the way that you've brought us together as a church family. I pray, Lord, that you use today's lesson to give us just more knowledge and a deeper understanding of how worthy you are of all our praise. Lord, may we be a people who live life to glorify you. And we just thank you so much for the way that you love us and the way that you provide for us. And I pray, God, that we may respond by loving you and loving others. It's in your name we pray. Amen.
I count on one thing. The same God that never fails will not fail me now. You won't fail me now in the waiting. The same God who's never late is working all things out. You're working all things out. And yes, I will lift you high in the lowest valley. Yes, I will bless your name. Fail me now, you won't fail me.